You know, a lot of people have been asking me lately, Kai, what's up with the flashy gold watches, the freezer around your neck? To which I say, to quote the great Sheikh Zula, it's bling blong, baby. It represents my lifestyle as a street savvy irreverent youth who lives large yet hungers for the next level in life. Welcome to the Astrobotany Show.
Young Mark Watney, study astrobotany. I make hanging gardens and nobody can stop me. Let's grow plants in space.
I'm your host, Kai Rasmussen, and today we'll be going over some of the basics of spaceflight plant biology. The first thing that I want to address here on the show is the history behind astrobotany. You'll often hear us refer to it as an emerging discipline or a new field, when in reality this is only half true. Astrobotany has been around since the beginning of spaceflight, and we've been growing plants in space since as early as 1970 and 1980. But enough from me, now we're gonna head over to the Historymobile. Alrighty, let's get right into it. In around the 1880s, some old head named Percy Gregg wrote Across the Zodiac, a big science fiction nerd story about a space traveler who went to Mars with plants. 15 years later, this guy named Constantine pretty much did the same thing, except it was a different book. And then let's fast forward to World War II here. And the Russian astronomer Gavril Adrianovich Tikhov was the first to define astrobotany and was appointed the head of the USSR sector of astrobotany. If you're looking for more information about this guy, good luck, because I wrote his Wikipedia page. 1946, the first seeds were launched on V2 rockets. 1971, seeds were flown around the moon and called moon trees, even though they weren't actually from the moon. 1982, the Soviet cosmonauts grew Atalyana on Salyut 7. They were the first to produce seeds and flower in space. So that's kind of a big milestone. 2016, the very beautiful zinnia flower bloomed aboard the International Space Station under the care of US astronaut Scott Kelly. And that is all she wrote.
Let's grow plants in space.
Oh, sorry, I didn't notice you there. Welcome to Item of the Week, where we go over an astrobotany item of the week. This week's item is plant in petri dish, or if you want to get technical, this would be Columbia wild type Arabidopsis thaliana in a 90 millimeter falcon petri dish, square. The point that I want to drive home here is that when we're sending plants to space, it's typically not a house plant or in a pot or in soil or anything like that. We actually sew these very small research organisms onto a plate with media. The media is a secret family recipe of ours. It's got some salt in it, it's got some nutrients, it's got some sucrose in it, and it basically has everything the plant needs. You can see here the plants are sewed on a clear media, and this media provides nutrients and also moisture that the plants need to successfully grow for maybe about 3 to 4 weeks until they get too big to be in the petri dish. Our media is a special type of media. It's a little bit harder than regular gel, and the reason why is because it needs to resist the rapid acceleration of launch. Wait, should I say anything else about it or? See you next week.
Ooh. I need to take a moment just to stop and thank my teachers, my professors, my coaches, my role models and leaders. Thank you to Simon and Richard, and big ups to NASA, to Wisconsin, my school home, and soon all my